ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஸ்ரீ பகவத்கீதா 9th சாப்டர் பக்தி யோகம். பகவான் கிருஷ்ணா இஸ் எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங் தி மோஸ்ட் கான்ஃபிடென்ஷியல் பக்தி யோகம், விச் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் ராஜவித்யா ராஜகுஹ்யம் டு அர்ஜுனா. எம்பெருமானார் பகவத் ராமானுஜா ஹஸ் கிவன் பியூட்டிஃபுல் காமெண்ட்ரி for Bhagavad Gita in his Gita Bhashyam. Vedanta Charya has given Tatparya Chandrikai, which is another Sanskrit commentary. Puttur Sri Uvya Krishna Swami Iyengar has given Tamil commentary based on these two Sanskrit commentaries. He has given also word by word meanings for every shlokam in his Tamil commentary. With the help of that, with the help of the English translation of that Tamil work, we are enjoying the simple meanings for Bhagavad Gita. We have seen up to the 19th shlokam in this chapter. After explaining about those who worship Him through Upasana Margam, through the Bhakti Yogam, Bhagavan explains about his own greatness of his being the Antaryami for everything in this world. Everything is Prakara for him and he is the Prakari. After explaining that, now in the 20th and 21st shlokams, Krishna is explaining about those who are interested in worldly pleasures and those who are pursuing Vedam for their worldly pleasures. So far we have seen about the Bhakti Yogis, those who are engaged in Bhakti Yogam. Their ultimate goal is Bhagavan and they perform all the anushtanams, the rituals, with that mindset. They also perform yagam, yagyam and so on. But their goal is to attain Bhagavan. But now, in these two shlokams, Krishna is explaining about those who are just interested in worldly pleasures, like going to Swargam and enjoying there. Let us see these two shlokams together. First 20th shlokam. Traividhya mam somapaha putapapaha yagye ishtva swargatim prarthayante te punyam asadhya surendra lokam ashnanti divyan divideva bhogan. Let us see the word by word meanings for this shlokam. Traividhya, absorbed in deeds explained in three Vedams but not in Vedantam. In general, Vedam is divided into two parts. There is the Purva Bhagam, the first part, and then there is Uttara Bhagam, the second part. Purva Bhagam contains all the mantras and the methods of worship, and Uttara Bhagam has in detail all the intrinsic information about Bhagavan, his qualities, his greatness and so on. The Purva Bhagam is Vedam and Uttara Bhagam is known as Vedantam. Upanishads and all of that are included in Vedantam. So here Krishna is talking about those people who are simply attached to the Purva Bhagam only. They pursue the rituals highlighted in Vedam only for the sake of attaining pleasure in higher worlds such as Swargam, heaven. They are not focused, they are not interested to reach the ultimate abode of bliss, which is Paramapadam. They are limited in their view that they want to get greater pleasure in this world itself, in this material world itself. So that is the context here. Trividya, absorbed in deeds explained in these three Vedams, but not in Vedantam. They are not focused on Vedantam, they are only focused on Vedam. Somapaha, those who drink the Somaratha, the Soma juice, which is the remnants of Yajna performed to please Indra and all. So these Yajnas, they are performed to please Indra and other Devatas, because they are the ones who are going to grant these performers to reach that abode and enjoy there. Putapapa, freed from sins which are hurdles to reach Swarga. The sins which are stopping them from reaching Swarga, they are removed for them. Yajnai, through yajnams, sacrifices which are focused on Devatas such as Indra and all. The difference between Upasaka, the Bhakti Yogi, and these other kind of people is that the Bhakti Yogi will also perform Yajna, but there they will pursue Bhagavan as Antaryami for these Devatas, Indra, Varuna and so on. But these people who are fully focused on just material pleasure, worldly pleasure, they will directly worship Indra and Varuna and so on. They will not worship Bhagavan, who is the Antaryami of these Devatas. Mam Ishtva, perform towards me, who is the Antaryami, indwelling super soul of such Devatas. So even though they don't know and they don't worship in that way, ultimately I am the Antaryami of all the Devatas. Swargatim prarthayante, praying to Indra and all for Swargam. They pray to Indra as part of that Yajna. They pray to Indra to acquire, attain the abode of Swargam. They punyam, without worldly sufferings, Surendra Lokam, the abode of Indra, the chief of Devatas, Asadhya, reach. Divi, many places in there. Divyan, wonderful pleasures which are better than those on this earth. Deva Bhogan, the pleasures of Devas. Ashnanti, enjoy. So absorbed in the deeds of Vedic rituals, these people who drink Somarasa, which is the remnants of the Yajna performed to please Indra and all, being freed from their sins, they reach Swarga through their yajnas, which are ultimately performed towards me, Krishna, but they don't know that. They are just praying to Indra and all for Swargam, and they reach the abode of Indra, the chief of Devatas, and that abode is without any worldly sufferings. That is, they don't, in this Swarga, they don't have the same sufferings as we have in earth. It is little bit better in Swarga, and they go to many places in that Swarga. Just like in earth we have so many places, in Swargam also there are so many places, and they go there and enjoy the pleasures of Devas, which are better than those on this earth. That is 20th shlokam. And 21st shlokam, in this shlokam Krishna explains how they are pushed out of Swarga once their punyam is exhausted. Tetvam buktva svargalokam vishalam kshine punye martya lokam vishanti evam trayi dharmam anuprapannaha gatha gatam kama kama labante. Let us see the word by word meanings. Vishalam, expansive, tam svargalokam, that pleasures in the svargalokam, buktva, enjoy, punye kshine, exhausting the punyam which was accumulated. So when punya is accumulated, when there is a lot of punya, they get to go to swargam, And once that punyam is exhausted, they are again pushed out of Swargam to the earth. So, which was accumulated, punyam which was accumulated, Martya Lokam Vishanti. After exhausting that punyam, they arrive in the earthly world, human world. Evam, in this manner, Trayidhamam Anuprapanna. Without knowledge in Vedanta, practicing the Pura Bhagam of Vedam only, Kama Kama, having desires in the desirable Swargam, etc., which are mentioned in them, which are mentioned in the Vedas only, Gata Gatam Labante, they attain the insignificant, temporary Swargam, etc., and again they return to the earth, which is material part of material world. So after enjoying the expansive pleasures in the Swargalokam, after exhausting the punyam which was accumulated, and that punyam is now exhausted due to enjoying in Swargam, they are again coming to this human world, which is earth, and in this manner, without understanding the Upanishads and the Vedantam, they only practice the Purva Bhagam, which is the foundational aspect in Vedam, and they have worldly pleasures, interest in worldly pleasures, and they, because of that, they attain the insignificant, temporary Swargam, and again come back to material world, this earth. So this joy in Swargam is insignificant compared to the joy in Parampadam. And it is also temporary because it doesn't last too long. So because of these limitations, these pleasures are not recommended generally. But those who have affinity towards just the material pleasures, they pursue this. And they keep on coming back to this earth. So the concept here is, usually when there is punya and papa, based on the punya and papa, one will take birth in the bhumi, bhulokam, that is earth. But if there is specific punya, which is accumulated by performing jyotishthomam or certain specific rituals and practice, then the result of that will be going to swargam. The punya will give them that joy. But once that punya exhausts, then they will come back to the earth here. Similarly, if someone does very grave sins, if someone commits big mistakes, then they will go to Naraka, enjoy the result of the sin, and once that experience is done, once that sins are exhausted, they will again come to earth. So this is the normal routine, and that is explained in these two shlokams. Next is 22nd shlokam. This is very popular shlokam. Everyone knows this shlokam. This is also recited as part of the Vishnu Sahasranama Adhyayam at the end. Ananyas chintayanto mam yejanas pariyupasate tesham nityabhiyuktanam yogakshemam vahamyaham. In this shlokam, Krishna is going back to those who are in the path of upasana to reach the higher goal. Krishna is saying that for those who are always thinking about him, those who are always worshipping him, for those who desire to be with him, for such persons, Krishna himself will grant them both yoga and kshema. Yoga means getting something which is not there. Kshema means retaining what is already acquired. So Krishna is the one who is going to help such upasakas, the bhakti yoganishtas, to reach Krishna, and it is Krishna who is going to retain them there without falling down. So he is the one who is going to protect them in the position which they acquired. Let us see the word by word meanings. Ananyaha, without any other goal. Anya means other. Ananya means without any other. So without any other goal than thinking about me. Mam chintayantaha, thinking about me always. Ye jana, those great souls. Mam pariyupasate, fully worshipping me with my auspicious qualities and wealth and my forms and so on. Just upasate means worshipping him. Pariyupasate means fully worshipping him, understanding his that he has auspicious qualities, he has beautiful forms, he has lot of opulence and so on, and pursuing him with all of these aspects. Nityabhi yuktanam tesham, for those persons who desire to be with me always. Aham, I, yoga kshemam, yoga to reach me, and shema to not having to return to samsaram. Vahami, bishchav, I grant to these great souls who are always thinking about me, who always are fully worshipping me, who don't want to leave me, who desire to be with me, I bestow them yoga, that is the opportunity of getting the fortune to be with me, and shema, which is retaining that fortune of being with me. So I am giving them what they don't have, as well as I am helping them preserve what they attain, says Krishna in this shlokam. With this we will stop today and we will continue on in the next session. Alvar Embarumanar Jiyarthirudigresharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.